Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. The news is that SpaceX is talking with US and Australian officials to land and recover one of its Starship rockets off the coast of Australia. This could mean a bigger presence for Elon Musk's company in the region, aligning with the stronger security ties between the two countries. After a successful Starship splashdown in the Indian Ocean in June, SpaceX wants to expand its testing. These landings and recoveries are key to the fast development of their reusable rocket, which is meant for satellite launches and lunar missions. So, SpaceX plans to launch Starship from Texas, land it in the sea near Australia, and recover it in Australia. This would require easing US export controls on advanced space technologies. They're also discussing towing the Starship to ports on Australia's western or northern coasts. These talks show US efforts to strengthen Australia's military amid regional tensions with China. SpaceX's operations in Australia could boost space defense collaborations and support Australia's growing space industry. Recent discussions have focused on regulatory challenges for bringing a recovered booster to Australia. Future plans might include launching from Australian facilities or land-based booster recoveries. SpaceX has previously tested its Falcon 9 landings at sea before moving to land. Meanwhile, SpaceX recently fired up the engines on its latest Starship spacecraft, getting ready for a test flight that could happen in a few weeks. On July 26, the company conducted a static fire with the 165-foot-tall Starship upper stage at its Starbase facility near Brownsville, Texas. This test involved firing all six Raptor engines of the rocket while it remained stationary. It's not clear when Flight 5 will launch. Elon Musk mentioned on July 5th that Starship could fly again in 4 weeks, hinting at a target date of August 2nd. However, reports now suggest the launch might happen in late August or early September. On the other hand, Starship enthusiasts, the Ring Watchers, recently provided key updates on the upgraded shields of Starship Flight 5. According to their insights, the fourth flight test of Starship was quite remarkable as it re-entered the atmosphere and made a controlled descent. Although the ship demonstrated impressive resilience, a certain amount of luck likely played a role in its survival. The challenges with the Starship heat shield, particularly the flaps, have been well known. With the success in the first re-entry test, SpaceX now has the opportunity to refine the heat shield's design and quality. Elon Musk highlighted that the most likely point of failure during re-entry could be the hinge of the flaps. These hinges, necessary for rotation, are difficult to seal properly, which can allow hot gases to penetrate. Before the fourth flight test, Musk had already expressed concerns about the heat shield and the hinges. The survival of the ship during re-entry was uncertain, and its successful landing came as a surprise to many. They continue to resolve these issues, learning from past experiences, including those with the space shuttle's heat shield. The first three flight tests helped SpaceX improve the tile attachment system, addressing some early problems, but re-entry presented new challenges that required further adjustments. The original heat shield consisted of approximately 18,000 hexagonal tiles. Most of these tiles were standard hexagonal shapes, simplifying installation and maintenance, while some unique shapes were used for specific areas. Tiles were attached either with pins welded to the hull or adhesive for curved surfaces. The pins created a gap behind the tiles, which could be filled with different materials. Tiles adhered with glue did not have an internal core and used red adhesive, which replaced the less effective blue glue used previously. Earlier ships also featured a white thermal blanket placed beneath the pin tiles. This blanket, along with a mesh material, helped maintain the position of the tiles and protected the steel from heat exposure. In areas with large curves, SpaceX used white felt as a gap filler between tiles. This addition helped cover gaps and improve the heat shield's overall effectiveness. Following the fourth flight test, SpaceX began preparing an upgraded heat shield for Flight 5. This involved replacing the entire heat shield and adding new materials underneath. Musk announced that the new heat shield would be significantly stronger and include an ablative layer for added protection if tiles were damaged. Some areas retained the old white felt, while new black ablative material was added to other parts of the ship. Additionally, a thin layer of felt was applied over the new material for extra protection. In the fourth flight test, SpaceX tried different types of heat protection on the rear of Ship 29. Elon Musk said that a two-layer heat shield worked well during re-entry, protecting the ship. This two-layer system, made of black material and thin felt, proved more effective than a single layer. Before this fourth flight test, the nose cone of Ship 29 already had this new upgrade, which was likely taken from the Block 2 design. This explains why the upgrade was applied quickly. The new heat shield tiles are stronger, though it's unclear exactly how. They might have improved the material or construction. The updated tiles look similar on the outside, but may have different internal features. SpaceX also replaced some of the adhesive used for the heat shield tiles. This change was based on lessons learned from the third flight test, not the fourth. Additionally, they added more gap filler to address inconsistencies in tile gaps. This filler helps protect against heat where there were gaps or poor fits. The improvements to Ship 30's heat shield should help prevent loss during re-entry. While there might still be issues to address, SpaceX continues to refine the design with each test. And now, SpaceX is asking the Federal Aviation Administration for permission to land its Super Heavy booster on land instead of in the Gulf of Mexico as originally planned. This change is causing delay to the flight, which was supposed to happen in early August. The FAA is reviewing this request and considering changes to SpaceX's launch license. The FAA has not said how long this review might take. The agency emphasizes safety in its reviews, while SpaceX prepares for the next mission and tests both the booster and upper stage Starship. The FAA is also looking into the potential safety issues of landing on land. In August, the FAA will also seek public feedback on an environmental assessment related to SpaceX's request to increase the number of launches and landings at its South Texas site to up to 25 times. Although SpaceX is continuing with its preparations, neither the company nor the FAA has provided an updated schedule for the next launch attempt, following the successful landing of the fourth flight in the Indian Ocean. Moreover, SpaceX has assured the public that the sonic booms from its Starship rocket are safe for people living nearby. This reassurance comes after the FAA reviewed SpaceX's plans to increase Starship launches in Texas. SpaceX explained that the sonic booms from the Starship rocket will be louder than those from the Falcon 9 rocket because Starship is larger. However, the company confirmed that these booms won't harm nearby residents. And that's all for now.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.